In this video, we're covering a relatively rare case of kinetic friction that's doing positive work. So the setup for the problem is that we're dropping, say, a pizza box onto a conveyor belt that's going very fast for a conveyor belt that's moving at 4 meters per second to the right. The box immediately begins to slip, it accelerates to the right, and it eventually is going so fast that it's going the same speed as the conveyor belt, and that's what we're asked for in part B. How far is it going to actually slide before it locks into place and just goes at the same speed as the conveyor belt? And let's not forget, we're given the coefficient of kinetic friction up here in the problem. So in part A, we're asked for the kinetic friction force on the box during the slipping phase. So when that box first lands, the conveyor belt is sliding to the right underneath the box. That creates a friction force pointing to the right. Of course, that's mediated by the normal force, so we start a force analysis on the box. So pointing straight down, we have the force of gravity on the box that's given by mg. And we'll go ahead and get a number on that, 1.1 for the mass, and we'll use 9.8 for g. And this gives us approximately 10.8 newtons. Pointing up, we have the normal force exerted on the box by the conveyor belt. And because there are no other forces acting vertically in the problem, that normal force must be exactly balancing the weight. So that also has a magnitude of 10.8 newtons. And next we get the friction force into the diagram. And that friction force has a magnitude of mu k, that's the coefficient of kinetic friction, multiplied by the normal force. So to answer part A, we just plug in that coefficient of kinetic friction, that was 0.25, and plug in the normal force, that's 10.8. And we arrive at a friction force of 2.70 newtons. Then to answer part B, that's the sliding distance before the box is moving at 4 meters per second and therefore locks into place on the conveyor belt. We need the acceleration as a first step for this, and we have a horizontal force of 2.7 newtons. We apply Newton's second law. We can write that as A equals F over M. Again, a horizontal force of 2.70 newtons, a mass of 1.1 kilograms. Into three significant digits, we arrive at an acceleration of 2.45 meters per second squared. Now we know the final velocity that we're interested in here. I'll call that V. That's 4 meters per second. We know the initial horizontal velocity was zero. We have the acceleration and we're interested in the sliding distance it takes to achieve that final velocity of 4 meters per second. Well, all these kinematic variables are related by the time-independent kinematics equation. That's V squared equals V naught squared plus 2A times the displacement X minus X naught. And so our usual default position is to call the initial position of the box zero. The final position is the sliding distance. We have the acceleration, the initial velocity, and the final velocity, so we should be able to solve for the sliding distance. Recall that V naught is also zero, so we can go ahead and solve for x by simply dividing both sides by 2a, and we get V squared over 2a. It's 4 squared over twice 2.45, and we get a total sliding distance of 3.27 meters. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.